Shalom, all praise to Yahweh Bashmiah Shah, double honor to the Apostle GMS. My name is Amnawa Allah, coming at you with another lesson. I'm not sure what I'm going to title this lesson, but Lord willing, through the Spirit, Yahweh Bashmiah Shah, I'll come up with a title as the show goes on. Right now it's 3:46 in the morning. You know, Spirit came to me to do a lesson on this particular scripture when I was reading this on a train, coming home from work a few days ago. You know, I had some other shows that I had done as well, but it's hard. My laptop is acting stupid, man. If for some reason I want to upload shows, 1 minute it does, and this minute it don't. You know. But this is scripture is 2 Ezra chapter 7 verse 68. But I'm gonna stop in verse 62. It says, "I answered then and said, I know, Lord, that the Most High is called merciful, and that He hath mercy upon them which are not yet come into the world." This is the prophet Ezra speaking to the angel Uriel. It says, "And upon those also that turn to His law, and that He is patient and long-suffered those that have sinned, as His creatures, and that He is bountiful, for He is ready to give where it needeth, and that He is of great mercy, for He multiplieth more and more mercy to them that are present, and that are past, and also to them that are to come. For if He shall not multiply His mercies, the world would not continue with them that inherit therein." So the Most High that multiplies mercies, the world would not continue with them that inherit them. Because if He didn't have mercy upon us, all of us would be dead. It says, and he pardoneth. For if he did not so of His goodness, if the Most High didn't pardon your sins, if He did not do so of His own goodness, of His goodness, that they which have committed iniquities, meaning sin upon sin, might be eased of them, the 10,000th part of men should not remain living. So if the Most High didn't pardon, right? If he did not pardon for the sake of His goodness, them that have committed iniquities might be eased of their iniquities. It says that the 10,000th part of men should not remain living. In other words, a 10,000th of the earth's population wouldn't even be living. Now, let's not get simple. No man would be living, okay? Because no man ever walked the earth not committing sin, except for the one in the world called Jesus Christ, whose name is Yahweh Shah in the Hebrew. So that's a hyperbole. H-Y-P-E-R-B-O-L-E. That means something that's not meant to be taken literally, just used to convey a deeper meaning. In other words, saying the 10,000th part of men would not remain living, in other words, the smallest amount of men wouldn't be living. Like if I say that bag weighed a ton, it didn't literally weigh 2,000 pounds. If I say, yo man, that grocery bag weighed a ton, it didn't literally weigh 2,000 pounds. That's hyperbole. It's not meant to be taken literally, it's just used to convey a deeper meaning that the bag was heavy. That's all. So what the scripture is saying is that the Most High didn't have mercy upon man, the 10,000th part would not remain living. Now let's go into some scriptures why that is. This is the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 7, verse 20. It says, "For there is not a just man upon earth that doeth good and sinneth not." So there's not one righteous man upon the earth that doeth good and sinneth not. We're all guilty of sin. The only person that's not guilty of sin is the one in the world called Jesus Christ, who we know Him as His real name in the Hebrew, which is Yahweh Shah. Okay? And you can read about that in the book of Peter. If I'm mistaken, I believe it's 1 Peter. Okay? Yep, 1 Peter chapter 2. Verse 22. So obviously when it says, "For there is not a just man upon earth that doeth good and sinneth not," obviously Yahweh Shah is excluded, of course, because he never committed sin. That's in the book of 1 Peter 2 and 22. I'll start in verse 21. 1 Peter 2 and 21. "For even hereunto were ye called, because Yahweh Shah also suffered for us, leaving us an example, that he should follow his steps, who did no sin, neither was guile found in his mouth." There you go right there. That's what we got to read. He did no sin. Next scripture I want to go to is the book of Psalms 39 and 5. Okay? Psalms chapter 39, verse 5. The scripture says, "Behold, thou hast made my days as an handbreadth, and my age is as nothing before thee." In other words, men don't live long. The scriptures speak about men living 70 years. which is 70 years, and then by strength of fourscore, which is 80 years, if I'm quoting that correctly, which I believe that I am, that's in the book of Psalms. All right, you brothers can look that up. So it says, behold, thou hast made my days as an hand breath, and mine age is as nothing before thee. Verily, meaning truly, every man at his best state is altogether vanity. Salah. So at the best state of man is still vanity. That word there for vanity in the Hebrew is habal, meaning like vapor or breath. So the very man in his best state is like a breath. And when you read on to the definition of vanity, it tells you empty. Okay? So man in his best state is vanity. It's like a breath. It's like a vapor. It tells you that in the book of James. Look at that real quick. Should be James the 4th chapter. I want to say. Yep. James chapter 4 verse 14. It says, whereas ye know not what shall be on the morrow. For what is your life? Okay. For what is your life? It is even a vapor that appeareth for a little while and then vanisheth away. So your life is like a little vapor. It's here 1 minute and it's gone the next, like a vapor. Like when it's cold outside and you breathe and you see the breath out of your mouth, it's there 1 minute, 1 second, then it's gone the next. So our life is like a vapor. And man in his best state is like a vapor. It's like a breath. It's empty. Why is that? Here 1 minute, going the next. Transitory, in other words. And I believe when you look at that word, you get the word transitory as well when you look it up in the blue letter. Here 1 minute, going the next. But why is that? Because as men, as men, we're all born in sin. And we all know, pursuing the book of Romans chapter 6, verse 23, that the wages of sin is death. So man that is at his best state is altogether vanity. Even the most righteous man on the earth is vanity at his best state. In his best state, because even in the most righteous man on planet earth's life, he's committed sin. Even in the life of the most righteous man on the planet earth, he's committed sin before. Therefore, at his best state, man at his best state is altogether vanity. No matter how many laws you keep, no matter how much you pray, no matter how much you fast, no matter how much you read the scriptures and live by the scriptures, at your best state, you're altogether vanity due to the fact that, why? We're born in sin. Alright? Scripture tell you, none are born among women have risen greater than John the Baptist. But John the Baptist committed sin. It doesn't tell you what sin he committed in the scriptures. But if we know pursuing the book of 1 Peter 2 and 22, the Lord did no sin. Alright? Then what that therefore means is that, and that that Lord was sinless, and it therefore means that every other man has committed sin. So John was the greatest prophet that ever lived, excluding Yahweh Shah, but even he committed sin. So man at his best state is altogether vanity. How can we get more into that? Let's go to the book of Job 14 and 1. These are examples why the scriptures tell you that the Most High multiplieth his mercies. He pardoneth those that commit iniquity. If not, the 10,000th part of man would not remain living. This is the book of Job. And I hope I'm edifying you, brothers. This is Job 14 and 1. Man that is born of a woman is a few days and full of trouble. Let's stop right there. It says, man that is born of woman is a few days and full of trouble. Now, obviously, once again, Yahweh Shai is excluded. Now, let's get into that real quick. Man that is born of a woman. Was Yahweh Shai born of a woman? Yeah, he was born of a woman. He was born through the physical act of sex with his father Joseph and his mother Mary. Yahweh Shai was born through the physical act of sex. But when it says born of woman, Yahweh Shai is excluded from that, because though you came out of a woman through the physical act of sex between a man and a woman, Joseph and Mary, Yahweh Shai came what? He came down from heaven. He was born of the Holy Spirit, which the Holy Spirit is what? The Word. Because Yahweh Shai was that child of prophecy that was written up in the Word when you go back into the book of Isaiah, the 7th chapter. All right? Let me get to further give you some more, a great idea that. I'm going to Jeremiah, the first chapter, real quick. Jeremiah 1. And then I'm going to go to the book of John 3 and 13. To help you brothers understand this a little better. Jeremiah 1 and 4. Then the word of the Lord, then the word of Yahweh Bashmael Shah came unto me, saying, before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. So the Most High is saying to Jeremiah, before I formed you in the belly, I knew thee. Meaning before you were formed in your mother's womb, I knew who you were. Right? So if he knew you before you was formed in your mother's womb, then where were you before then? You were in the heavens. You were in the spirit world. Okay? So before we're put in our mother's womb, our spirits are in heaven. Alright? Before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. Alright? Before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. So before before you came out of your father, before you were put, that's what I should have said. Before you came out of your father and was put into your mother, your spirit was already in heaven. Alright? So before your father shot you out through ejaculation, through the act of sex, your spirit was in heaven before your spirit came down. And you came out of your father and went into your mother. Your spirit was in heaven. So the scripture says, before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee, and before thou camest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee, and I ordained thee to be a prophet unto the nations. So before Jeremiah went into the womb of his mother, the Most High knew him. And before he came out of the womb, he was already sanctified. He was already called to what? And I ordained thee to be a prophet unto the nation. In other words, Jeremiah was predestined. He was preordained to already be a prophet before he physically came upon the earth when the spirit was in the heavens. He was already set up to be a prophet. Alright? And the same thing applied to Yahusha. Before Yahusha came on the earth in physical form as the Messiah, Jeremiah 3 and 13. I'm sorry, John 3 and 13. Saint John 3 and 13. And no man hath ascended up to heaven, but he that came down from heaven, even the Son of Man which is in heaven. That's Tumo Yahusha. So Yahusha came down from heaven. Can I get another, is there another scripture I can get on that? Let me see. Yep, St. John 6 and 37. All that the Father giveth me shall come to me, and him that cometh to me I will no wise cast out. For I came down from heaven, not to do mine own will, but the will of him that sent me. So just as Jeremiah, the Most I knew who Jeremiah was before Jeremiah was formed in the womb, and Jeremiah was sanctified to be a prophet before he came out of the womb, right? Before he led a physical life on earth, the Most I knew he was because the spirit was in heaven. Before the Yahusha came on the scene as the Messiah, Yahusha's spirit was in heaven. Okay? And Yahusha was born through the physical. Therefore, the point that I'm getting at is that Yahusha was born in the Holy Spirit. He came down from heaven. Just as our spirits came down from heaven, but Yahusha was born in the Holy Spirit in regards to he was that child of prophecy, going back to the book of Isaiah 7 and 14. Because what is the Spirit? The Spirit is the Word, John chapter 6, verse 63. It is the Spirit that quickeneth. The flesh profiteth nothing. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. So when it says man is born of woman is a few days and full of trouble, that's excluding Yahusha. Okay? Because Yahusha wasn't born of woman the way we were. But Yahusha was born of the Spirit, because he was a child of prophecy, which is written in his word, which is the Spirit. Going back to Isaiah the 7th chapter, the 14th verse. So when you go back, when it says, man born of a woman is a few days and full of trouble, why will man... I'll read the scripture again and break it down. Break down the next point. Job 14 and 1, it says, man that is born of a woman is a few days and full of trouble. Why is he a few days? I could read the next verse. Let me read the next verse too. He cometh forth like a flower and is cut down, and he fleeth as a shadow and continueth not. Talking about his life. So if you go back to the first verse, it says, man that is born of woman is a few days and full of trouble. Why is he a few days and full of trouble? Because man that is born of woman is born in what? Is born in sinful flesh. He's born in sinful flesh. And therefore becomes susceptible to temptation, and becomes and is actually given over to the temptation. Because why? You're born of a woman. You're not born of the Spirit like Yahusha was, because Yahusha was born in sinful flesh just as we are born in sinful flesh. But Yahusha was never given over unto the temptation. Let's go to the book of Romans 8 chapter. See, the Spirit is flowing now. Flowing more. This is Romans 8. And 1. There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Yahusha, who walk not after the Spirit. I'm sorry. Who walk
not after the flesh, but after the spirit. For the law of the spirit of life in Yahushua hath made me free from the law of sin and death.
I'm trying to get to the, you know, down to the point, you know, due to the interest of time.
It says, for what the law could not do, in that it was weak through the flesh.
Right, for what the law could not do, in that it was weak through the flesh. Why? Because we are born in the flesh, and we couldn't keep the law 100% perfectly.
Okay? So, for what the law could not do, in that it was weak through the flesh, the Most High sending his own son in the likeness of sinful flesh, Yahusha came in the likeness of sinful flesh, and for sin, condemned sin in the flesh. And for sin, condemned sin in the flesh. So Yahusha was born in sinful flesh, just as we are born in sinful flesh. But Yahusha condemned sin in the flesh. Because when you're born into the flesh, you're given over to the temptations of the flesh. Alright? Lasciviousness, adultery, lying, theft, or being false witness, theft, and no man of sin, which you become susceptible to because you're born in sinful flesh. Yahusha was also born in sinful flesh, but Yahusha condemned sin into flesh. Condemned sin in the flesh, because though he was born in sinful flesh, he never committed sin. All right. So when it says man that is born of a woman is a few days and full of trouble, Yahusha is excluded from that, because Yahusha was born of a physical woman the way we were, but Yahusha was born of the spirit. He wasn't born in sin the way we were born in sin. Because 1 Peter 2 and 22 tells you Yahusha never committed sin, even though he was born in sinful flesh. So Yahusha condemned sin in the flesh. He never committed sin. We have committed sin. So that scripture ain't talking about Yahusha. Alright? So, let's go back to, I'm going to go to another scripture. I got scripture written down right there. So hope you brothers understood that. If not, you know, you brothers could rewind it. You know? Because Yahusha was born a woman in the physical sense. That's what I'm saying when I say he was born a woman in the physical sense. He just wasn't born carnally the way that we were. In the aspect of being given over unto sin. Okay? Which I already explained. Matthew chapter 19, verse 17. And he said unto him, why callest thou me good? There is none good but one. This is when one came unto Yahusha and called him good master. And this is Yahusha's reply. Because he came unto Yahusha, called him good master, and said, what must thou do to enter into eternal, that he may have eternal life? Yahusha said, and he said unto him, why callest thou me good? There is none good but one, that is the Most High. But if thou wilt enter into life, keep the commandments. So the point I'm getting at is that Yahusha said there is none good. I got another scripture, Psalms, none good but the Father. See that? And because, and the reason why Yahusha said that, because Yahusha sinned in the past life as Adam. Okay? If thou can perceive it. Psalms 143, it should be verse 2. Psalms chapter 143, verse 2. It says, Psalms 143 and 1. Hear my prayer, O Yahweh Bashem Yahshah, give ear to my supplications. In thy faithfulness answer me, and in thy righteousness. And enter not into judgment with thy servant, for in thy sight shall no man live and be justified. Why? Because we've all committed sin. Alright? Excluding Yahweh Shah, of course. Oh, said no man justified. Yahweh Shah is a man, so that gotta be talking about him too. It's not talking about him, man. Obviously he's excluded. So you gotta read the Bible, the whole Bible. And I'm gonna end it off with Isaiah 64 chapter and the 6th verse. Alright? Isaiah 64 verse 6. It says, but we are all as an unclean thing, and all our righteousness are as filthy rags. Right? All of our righteousness are as filthy rags. Because though you may commit acts of righteousness by, you know, keeping the laws, praying, fasting, studying the scriptures, our righteousness is still as filthy rags, because we can't keep the law 100% perfectly, and we still do find fault. We still go off. So our righteousness are as filthy rags. I mean, though we may commit righteous acts, we're still filthy because we're stained with sin. And we all do fade as a leaf, and our iniquities like the wind have taken us away. So our righteousness is filthy rags, man. So though we may commit acts of righteousness, we still do find fault. That's the reason why the scripture has said in the book of 2 Ezra chapter 7, verse 68, the Most High pardoneth with his goodness the iniquities. I'm going to read it right here. 2 Ezra 7 and 68. And he pardoneth, for if he did not sow of his goodness, that they which have committed iniquities might be eased of them. And he pardoneth, for if he did not sow of his goodness, that they which have committed iniquities might be eased of them. Might be eased of their iniquities. That's why I said them. The ten thousandth part of men should not remain living. Why? Because our righteousness are the Lord's filthy rags. Man in his best state is altogether vanity. In the Most High sight, no man justified. And man born of woman is a few days and full of trouble. Except Yahweh Shah, because Yahweh Shah was physically born through a man and woman having sex. But Yahweh Shah was born in the Holy Spirit because he was that child of prophecy. And though being born in the sinful flesh, pursuing the Romans the 8th chapter, Yahweh Shah condemned sin in the flesh but never committed sin, which is written in the book of 1 Peter 2 and 22. So that excludes Yahweh Shah. So with that, all the brothers learn something, I'm going to say, Shalom.